Teachers of Reddit, what are some positive trends you have noticed in today's youth? Nerd geek culture is more accepted. University teacher here. My students put in way more effort than I did at their age. Granted, the system has pushed them in that direction as well. But they typically have a better idea of where they want their car to go and are willing to put in the effort to obtain that goal. By comparison, I and my cohort mucked about a bit more. Students are not afraid to just be nice to each other. I teach elementary art and it is so nice when a kid who is pretty unskilled in art show another kid their work, and instead of getting laughed at, like when I was in school, kids are just as sweet and will say things like, "Wow, I really love that." Quote, "I hear kids telling other kids, 'I think your work is beautiful,' or 'I really like your ideas.' And I just think of when I was in art, kids made fun of my work. In general, I really don't see kids being bullies as much as they were when I was a kid. I went to school in a really nice district too with few problems, but I was bullied. Kids here have a much worse home life than kids at my old school, and while they could choose to take it out on others, they don't. Kids help each other too. They know if a student is special and will try to help that student out. They'll offer to walk them to the bathroom or help them with their drawing or very politely tell them to be careful with things. My GF is a teacher and she is amazed at how uncool drinking and driving is. Kids are like, 'That's stupid, you will kill someone.' They literally make fun of kids who do it. In my day, everyone drove drunk. Very positive change. They seem generally kinder to each other, especially to the kids who are different. When I was in school, the kids who didn't speak English as their first language, or were a little quirky or had disabilities, were either avoided or viciously bullied. Today, that seems to be the exception rather than the norm. Not a teacher but work the 2 to 10 shift at the local gas station across from the junior high and high school. Kids these days are a lot nicer, more likely to donate to our fundraisers, and they have zero problem for paying for each other's stuff when someone's short. I worried about my son, who has mild autism. For the first 10 years of his life, I kept telling him that middle school would be hard, kids would tease him, etc., and that high school would be even harder in the same respect. 15 years ago, I would have been right. Fast forward to now, and I'm constantly amazed and grateful for how well he is treated. Even jock kids and big snotty idiot kids who would make perfect bullies are inclusive, kind, and even sometimes protective of my son. I've told all of them how appreciative I am, and even got a few of them Christmas presents this year. Love those kids. High school teacher here. The most admirable quality of the rising generation is their ability to take anything, and I mean anything, and turn it into a meme. My daycare kids are much more likely to wash their hands than my generation was when we were there. Age lol. Girls ask boys out more often. Boys are starting to expect girls to be more frank and straightforward with what they want more often. Other than that, just like my colleagues, generally kinder, more generous, understanding of differences, mature. On the other hand, I find them generally more sad, maybe more cynical, and overall quite happily pessimistic toward the future. A kind of AHAAH, we're so fucked vibe I feel sometimes. I'm not a teacher, but my GF's mom is a teacher, and it sparked a dialogue. With the dawn of meme culture, kids are getting competitive with comedy at an early age. When I was a kid, I had undiagnosed mental health issues, so I was bullied a lot. And the only thing that kept me alive was developing my sense of humor. Sad as it is, young people have a pecking order in cliques. But a few things can transcend those boundaries, and one of those is humor. Coincidentally, I was into internet humor, meme culture, and PC games way before my peers were. Wanna hear something crazy? I was bullied for that. Specifically and mercilessly. If you ran a meme page and had a nice gaming PC at 10 today, you would be a god. It's honestly made a lot of kids that don't fit in have at least something in common with their peers. All you have to do is yell Fortnite or whatever meme is going around that week and boom, you have a friend. I had one time where I was able to make friends like that, and that was when Pokemon came out. Similar concept. You might think that kind of stuff is cringe, or annoying, or stupid. But if it can prevent someone from wanting to kill themselves at 12 like I was, I'll allow it. Of course I don't need to have it anywhere near me. But that's a different matter. They are generally independent and self-reflective. When I first started teaching, I thought I had simply lucked out getting students who were consistently bright, engaged and curious, but having now taught at 3 different universities on 2 different continents, it seems to be a general trend across universities. They are also, as noted elsewhere, generally kind and empathetic, and both my male and female students are usually pretty emotionally mature. With high schoolers, I really noticed how better their style is. Super random, but compared to how lazy I dressed in high school, it's impressive. I asked my wife, primary teacher, and she says empathy and adaptability are the 2 traits she has seen dramatically improve over her last 15 years. Kids seem to be better at putting themselves in another's position and understanding their situation. Also, they seem to be much more flexible with changes, whether in the classroom or the outside world. Spouse to a high school teacher. She had to say, they were born into the internet and social media, it is not something they had to learn. Also, as a result of which, they are also more self-reliant with research. And most importantly, contrary to the largest complaints, today's kids are extremely hardworking, and the less judgy of nerds, less judgmental in general. As a student currently in high school, the big thing for our generation, at least in decent schools, is that failure isn't cool. Sure, if you suck up to the teacher and obsess over studying, you'll get made fun of a bit. But the kids getting Fs get made fun of a lot more. A lot of the popular kids are actually really smart and get top grades. There's a general awareness that we all need to do well and a lot of aspiration for the future. Kids are openly kind and loving regarding their parents. I had a tough football player day in class once. I love my mom. She's my best friend. I see the old ugh my parents suick mentality falling by the wayside recently. I am a teacher at a high school in Missouri. All of the stereotypes you hear, see in rural high schools are still prevalent. However, almost every group works harder academically. It is no longer cool to get Fs and fail. Even country boys who will never leave the farm or go to college care about getting passing grades. 600 plus students in our HS, by the way. I teach junior high. Celebrity status of jocks is over. They are just one more social group on campus. Smart kids have more respect from their peers. Multidisciplinary excellence seems to be more valued than ever. They really get each other, as much as they diss on each other, joke around, and yes, get to the point of blows. They can usually put issues aside, sometimes to a fault, but overall they are pretty understanding of each other. Not a teacher, but a former after-school care counselor. Even though it may have just been the school's rules conditioning, the kids were generally so good at apologizing, owning up to their actions, and being accepting of others' apologies. After whatever situation transpired has calmed down, of course, they always knew to kindly and carefully approach whoever they hurt, make eye contact, and word their apologies in such a way that effectively communicated their apology for the correct reasons, and and those being apologized to always knew to say, "I accept your apology," as opposed to, "It's okay." Kids in my day couldn't figure those kind of communication skills out until at least middle school or high school. The only time I would get a sarcastic "sorry," accompanied with an eye roll and running away would be from a kindergartner or an older child facing other difficulties. I taught art for a spell a while back. I know that a lot of people say shit like, "Oh, these children and they're all consuming technology." But a lot of kids are so excited about learning to make things using their devices. A big part of the sculpture class one taught was to make a statement using a 3D printed sculpture. Even take something like Minecraft. I know it's a big meme, but it's a huge sandbox to build things. I remember being a young teen when I came out, we would get so complex with our builds. Kids are learning to create in an incredibly different way. It can be really irritating when they latch onto something and run it into the ground. But they love learning new things and creating new things in an increasingly relevant way. This thread is dope. It's given me hella hope for the future. As someone who is a youth of today, I've literally never seen bullying where I live. People are kind of dicks sometimes, but not bullies. Not a teacher, but I've noticed that a lot of children seem to be questioning authority rather than flat out rebelling. I wonder how the subculture kids are doing. Are there still goths and punks? I miss my clique of goth teens from high school. Those were the best days. The 8-year-olds I teach really make a huge deal about plastic.
We watched the Blue Planet 2 episode with them, and since then they have been so mindful and really
want to protect the oceans. Secondary school. There's a lot less cigarette smoking than 20 years ago. A lot of kids use their Juuls. But to be honest, I'd rather have that than cig smoking. Video games are a lot more accepted. Not just a niche played by nerds in arcades after school. Every social group plays video games. Kids are a lot more literate than when I was in school. Even if they speak English as a second language, the ubiquity of the internet has done wonders for basic literacy. Although a lot of mistakes due to the way words sound are still common. There, should, of, and could have, etc. Getting pretty witty. Today we were talking about India and sacred cows. A kid asked, does that mean his mom is sacred to Indians? America's youth has a renewed interest in flossing. Dentists rejoice. The majority of my students are in the 18 to 22 age range. I'm 37. For reference, students are far kinder than they ever were when I was a student. They go out of their way to help each other. And they're much less judgmental than my cohort was. For the most part, they are really polite and respectful. I know a lot of professors deal with problems from cell phones. But I find that if I tell them to use their phones respectfully and only for class purposes, they do. The only real problem I seem to have with this cohort is the constant headphone wearing. But I think that's a battle I'm just going to lose. Don't forget to share, like, and subscribe for more content.